Hello everyone, I'm Dr. Komal, working as an assistant professor in Department of Pharmacy from RPIT Medical and Technical Campus. So hope all are you fine and safe. So today we are discuss about the topic that is vaccine and vaccination process. So let's start. What is vaccine and vaccination? According to WHO, a vaccine is a biological preparation that improves immunity to a particular disease, and vaccination, it is the administration of antigen material to stimulate the immune system of an individual to develop adaptive immunity to a disease. So this is the historical background of vaccine and vaccination. The word vaccine was first used by Edward Jenner in 1796. The word vaccine was derived from Latin word that is vaccao, and he firstly cured the disease smallpox through his self-made vaccines. So there are several types of vaccines are available in your market, that is live vaccines, attenuated live vaccines, inactivated killed vaccines, and genetically engineered vaccines. So let's start, that is live vaccine. These vaccines contain live microorganisms. After application, the vaccines produce high number of vaccine agent over a fairly long period of time, and this helps to produce a strong immunological response, a bodily defense reactions that recognizes an invading substance and produces specific antibodies against that antigens. Next, that is attenuated live vaccines. Such vaccines contain live attenuated microorganisms. An attenuated vaccine is a vaccine created by reducing the virulence of a pathogen but still keeping it alive. This is weak vaccine and the degree of pathogenicity is low. Next, that is inactivated vaccines. It is also known as killed vaccines. Some vaccines contain killed microorganisms that have been destroyed with heat, radioactivity, or antibiotics. It is not capable of spreading the agent to birds, and they have the capacity to produce immunity when used through vaccinations. Next, that is vector vaccines. A vector vaccine is a vaccine that uses a chemically weakened virus to transport pieces of virus in order to stimulate an immune response. It is also known as genetically engineered vaccines. It is called vector vaccine because it plays immune stimulating components from one agent to another agent known as a vector. And this vector is usually a very large virus, that is pox or herpes virus. Only known disease producing components are added to the vectors. That's why disease reactions